Food is the main need for every living creature. And the human being is not an exception to that. But it is no longer an issue in developed countries to reach food in order to survive. The success of food security in developed countries is due to the fact that they have already completed their cold chain infrastructure and developed a culture of food storage. When we look into the food pyramid, showing the food consumed by human being, it is going to be easier to comprehend the link between food security and cold chain. At the very bottom of the pyramid take place the rice, pasta, and various bakery products made from cereals. They are followed by respectively fruits and vegetables and protein sources such as meat, fish, chicken, and dairy products. The top of the pyramid is including fat and sugar as the least consumed products. With a detailed look to this pyramid-shaped chart, one can easily realize that almost 70% of food consumed by humans is subject to cold chain application. Food security has three components: to ensure continuous supply of food, to keep food prices within affordable range, to supply healthy food. We can say we made our food secure only when we can provide a constant flow of healthy food at reasonable prices. Unfortunately, the continuous supply of healthy food at affordable prices cannot be provided in the same way everywhere in the world. The reason is not the lack of production, but food producers believe that producing is enough itself to ensure the food security. In fact, producing is not enough solely. Food should be accessible and tradable all year, long at reasonable prices in every region of any given country.
Okay.
This determination requires strategical plans to store food up to the point of consumption. It is being observed two main obstacles in developing countries have to face when trying to establish a cold chain. The first one concerns the infrastructure. Developing countries do not have cold storages in adequate volume, nor they have no enough vehicles to transport the food among these storage facilities. The second obstacle is about the food storage culture. It is important for food-producing countries to learn and practice the food storage culture. We do have to keep in mind for sure that we cannot sell our products to other cities or to other countries if any available cold chain has not been established over there yet. The cold chain, which ensures you can get the healthy, fresh food at their best conditions, has two main aspects: cold storages and refrigerated vehicles transporting food among those storages. Cold warehouses are not very different from each other. They are made of cold rooms of various dimensions with temperature regulating capabilities. These warehouses also have monitoring system and technical units. The cold warehouses include refrigerating systems, sliding doors, weigh bridges, loading and unloading ramps, and bellows. Beside the necessity of establishment of cold storage for each food, there is also need for city warehouses, which can meet food demands of city populations in order to ensure the food security. These warehouses can be considered as the refrigerators of the cities. Without these warehouses, it cannot be possible to talk about food security. In principle, in the cities where there is not an already established warehouse, it is an urgent need to build a cold storage facility with a volume of 10,000 tons for each population of 1 million. A storage facility of 10,000 tons can provide every 20 persons with 1 meter cube of storage space within a city having 1 million of population. The city warehouse, where every kind of food from vegetables to fruits, from cheese to ice cream, and even to meat, fish, and chicken can be stored, is the most important element of food security. Refrigerated transport, which provides an uninterrupted cold chain between producers and consumers, is the most important factor linking together all settled storage facilities. In road transportation, frigorific vehicles such as trucks, vans, or trailers having their own bodies with self-refrigerating setup are the most commonly used cold chain vehicles around the world. In sea and rail transport, the most common method is to use of refrigerated containers called reefers. In frigorific air transport, it is common to use dry ice rather than complicated refrigerating systems. If you do not have enough space and can spare required budget, you have a much better solution than city storehouses to ensure the food security. This is the food centers, where you can gather the producers and storehouses on the same site. There is need to bringing all small and medium-scaled producers and storehouse owners supplying food together in a common food center. This must be designed in such a manner that it permits to be expanded. The large storage spaces in this facility enable a constant food supply, and so the food prices become more stabilized. The most profitable, with the most reasonable cost, can be achieved in this way. These food centers ensure your food security. The return period of any cold warehouse investment in developing countries does not exceed 4 years. In fact, most of the time it is shorter than 4 years. Investment in cold chain is highly lucrative as well, as it is a social investment with its contributions to food security in any given country. We think that continuous access to the healthy food, which is the main need and right of a human being, must be no longer an issue for the humanity. And we do continue to preserve our food. Because we know it well, a better future is in our hands. We only need to protect our food and use our energy wisely.